The genre of political satire is such a rich legacy, going all the way back to Chaplin and The Dictator. Yeah. I'm curious for you, as someone who's often hailed as one of the best examples of it in the modern arena, what is the essence of getting political satire right, and how important do you think it is?
Oh, wow, that's a huge question. I mean, with me, it's just instinct. You know, you talk about, you make something about what it is you're... You have to be passionate about it. Now, whether that's passionately supporting something or passionately angry about it, you know, you have to have a genuine emotion. And I think, you know, if someone says they're doing a satire, but they're just doing it because it's a job, then I don't think you get that sense of it engaging with what's going on in the world, you know.
What emotion was it that fueled this one?
Fear. Simon Russell Beale in mind for Barrier, and I spoke to him very early on, and he was up for it and he loved the script. So once you do that, you then start working out from that who would be the perfect foil for Simon. Okay, Steve Buscemi, you can't get two more different types of people, yeah? And then you think, right, great, we've got these two, we've got American, we've got British, we could do with more American voices. Jeffrey Tambor, great hero of mine. Another great hero, Michael Palin. Paul Whitehouse, who, you know, I've always rated as a fantastic actor, but has always done his own material, so good to get him in. And then, you know, I like seeing people like Rupert Friend, who is known as a kind of an American sniper in Homeland. It's great that he gets to do a great comic turn. And Andrea Riseborough, who's just like a chameleon. Every film she does, she's so different, you know. And so it carries on, you know. It was like that. So it was like a kind of building up and assembling a kind of team, bit by bit, really, so that you got the best mix of people and mix of acting traditions as well.